Hello everybody, my name is Ibrahim Watar, aka Ebi Watt, and what are we reacting to today? It's 22 minutes of dominant SEDIN shifts. So I've gotten a lot of recommendations about the SEDIN twins. I have no idea what to expect here. I'm not sure if I should do this as one video because this is a pretty long 22 minute video. So I think I'll do the first 10, 11 minutes as a part, and then I'll do the second part as well. So I think this is a video that's enjoyable. I'm hoping it's enjoyable. I've gotten recommendations about it, so it must be good. Before we get into it, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Comment down below what you'd like me to react to next, and I'll do the best effort to check it out. Let's not talk a lot and get straight into this. Okay, let's go.
Get out of the zone and get on the attack quickly.
Draper, I'm interested to see what happens in this video. Henrik SEDIN.
Lucas Krajicek under pressure from Chris Draper.
What's happening here?
Salo on the other side. Maltby was watching him. So Salo switches sides now. Maltby's interfered with.
What is going on?
SEDIN, Salo, Daniel SEDIN.
Daniel SEDIN. So Henrik SEDIN and Daniel SEDIN. That's their names now. Oh my goodness. They are really fighting to keep that puck in that part of the rink.
Oh.
They're really like... Man, the defense is squirming. The defense is squirming. Oh, oof. Man, there was a lot happening. They really were freaking keeping that puck on that end of the rink. That's insane.
Lucas Krajicek finishes some SEDIN magic, 2-1 Vancouver. The SEDINs have tremendous skill, but how this goal is scored is the work in the corner along the boards. Henrik and Daniel out.
Yeah, they were. They just kept passing it, controlling it in that side of the rink, and until they scored a goal. Wait, and this wasn't even a power play, right? But it freaking felt like a power play. What is this? Let's see what happens here. Oh.
Henrik SEDIN, good pressure there from Sheldon Surrey.
Very good play by Surrey. The defense had been sagging off a little bit. And Surrey saw that SEDIN was on his own and stood
okay.
Up and got
the play. Here's Ryan Kessler.
Oh, keeping it in. Oh, great control so far.
Henrik SEDIN to Daniel. Back to Henrik.
Now my goodness.
In front. Matthias Olin takes the shot, didn't get it through. Swatted away.
Oh, good steal. They kept it in.
Escapes.
Lucas Krajicek. This is like, you don't know when the goal
Ryan
is coming.
Kessler against Matt Green, who blocked the centering pass.
Henrik SEDIN.
In for Daniel. Krajicek's come to the net.
Oh my goodness, where is it?
The skate of Jarrett
Stoll. This is a power play, okay. Because I'm like, what the frick is going on? They must be scoring a goal right now, right?
Daniel, Henrik. There's that.
Oh my goodness.
Pass or the tip in.
Oof, he saved it.
But still, the Canucks
he kept
the
it in.
Krajicek saw Wallace in the save and he couldn't freeze it. Oilers need a whistle. Daniel SEDIN.
Man, the defense must be exhausted at that point.
In front, Olin shoots, hit the post.
Oh.
Henrik SEDIN.
My goodness.
Lucas Krajicek. Henrik to Daniel. Tip just wide. Their patented slap.
Oh my goodness.
Here for a minute, 40 seconds.
This is literally relentless.
Henrik
like
SEDIN.
They are just relentless
Daniel.
Right now.
Henrik.
The defense must be exhausted.
Lucas Krajicek.
Oh my goodness.
Almost 2 full minutes now. And the Oilers haven't been out of their own zone. Penalties over. Olin, Henrik SEDIN, Daniel SEDIN can't get a good shot away.
Oh my goodness.
SEDIN,
what is going on?
What a shift. Daniel shoots.
Oh wow. After just a barrage on that defense. Yo, that defense was like on edge for like, I don't know how many minutes straight. That's insane. That defense was like, okay, screw this. This is too much for us to handle.
Of a 2 minute and 20 second shift, Daniel Sedin makes it 2-0. And the Oilers penalty killers are absolutely exhausted.
Yeah. Just excellent. I would imagine how exhausted they are. They were literally running around like crazy.
The power play ends, but the Sedins continue on. Desperation in front. Stoll goes
That's
down.
Crazy.
Tarnstrom gets it to the wall, but Henrik Sedin keeps it alive. Seam pass and then
oh. That's a great goal, though. He hit it like right, good pass, and then hits it right in the corner. That's fantastic right there.
So Bieksa gets the return pass from Olin and flips the puck in. Curls on the forecheck, has the only Canucks goal tonight so far. Gets it over to Henrik in the left circle. Now to Daniel, to Sallow at the point. Puck hopped on, he couldn't shoot. Daniel will on a pass from Sallow. Pass is deflected. As Burrows got a stick on it, and then
oh my goodness,
rebound. Now Burrows trying to work
what
it
is
back
going on
the backhand, had the puck poked away, kept on
really good at keeping that puck in
as it's cleared out.
Oh, now it's cleared out. Okay,
Sallow in the neutral zone ahead to Daniel just inside the line. Burrows is tied up trying to get after it, knocks it loose to Henrik in front for Daniel. He was checked because he tried to shoot. Bergeron,
man, this is like so much suspense. I can't imagine watching this game live as well.
Now Mitchell pinching down, throws it out front. Henrik didn't see it coming. He gets the loose puck off the boards. In the right circle now for Daniel as they turn on the pressure. Wilder tired. Down low to
this is
Burrows.
Just
it back to the point
a
to
lot
sell.
Of pressure on the defense. Though, like I imagine myself Mitchell. Being on the defensive
Daniel,
end of this.
And behind the net to Burrows. Somebody's
it's exhausting.
Go Henrik with the puck behind the goal. Burrows out front in the slot. Mitchell pinching down from the point. Fans want a shot. Now comes to the point to Daniel. His long shot deflects wide. Henrik behind the goal.
Back my goodness.
Burrows trying to get there. Sallow
comes yo, the effort. The effort it's taking
six
right now to get a shot on goal. Shoot it.
Here's Henrik with a
oh,
shot.
My goodness.
As Daniel passed to the side of the goal.
Oh, what a pass.
Henrik was stolen by Backstrom. Canucks change their defenseman. Adler winds up. Doesn't shoot. Watch the line. It's not a power play, but it looks like it, one. It's a two-minute shift.
It literally looks like a power play. That's a crazy thing.
To Henrik at the point. Daniel in the slot. Doesn't shoot. Gets it loose. Puck comes to Willie Mitchell. Now to Adler at the blue line.
Shoot
Mitchell,
it.
Top of the circle.
Oh, man. This
shot.
Is nerve-wracking. Does somebody shoot
now
it?
He shoots. Deflects wide of the goal. Burrows knocks it loose behind the net. Plays it over to Daniel on the left side. This is unbelievable.
It literally looks like a power play. They've been on this for so long.
Burrows steals side of the goal. Tries to feed it out front. Finally, it's scooped up and carried to the blue line and out.
The only thing missing was sweet Georgia Brown.
Here they come. Odd man rush. Dimitra right in. Shoots high.
Oh.
And the puck goes out of play.
Listen to this place. Oh, that's hot.
Man, that's an insane. It felt like a power play. They were literally like driving the defense crazy.
Burrows, Henrik, and Daniel, what a shift. I swear it was 2 minutes. 6:43 now remaining in the second.
It felt like more than 2 minutes.
It's Minnesota 2 and Vancouver 1.
Daniel, Henrik. More like what we're used to seeing from
let's
the
see what's more to see here.
I would say why you'd see this from Vigneault too is you think of the criticism that they've taken during the season about not scoring and getting involved offensively. You got a night where it might be a point night, give them an opportunity to shot.
Okay,
Daniel to Henrik.
Oh,
Daniel again.
Look at that look at that control. The crowd's loving it.
Henrik. In comes Aaron Rome. Burrows.
Ooh.
Backhander stopping.
Goal. That's amazing. Absolutely amazing. I feel like they're really good at just controlling on that end of the, on the offensive end and just bombarding the defense. Just exhausting the defense. Pass, 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 control, like all the time.
It seemed that Aaron Rome gets his first playoff goal. The puck's
it's fantastic, honestly fantastic. That's amazing.
Well, superstar players know when they've got an opportunity to shine, and this is just the end of a great shift.
Boom.
Girls with the turnaround. Rome found himself behind the net, but followed up the play.
So I guess they call it a shift then, when you're, I guess, shifting. I don't know. I need a better explanation as to what exactly a shift means. I guess it means a shift in the, like, you're shifting, your offense is always on that side of the ring. Okay, I guess we'll stop it. Yeah, I'll stop it there, and the rest will be in a part two. I'll post that later as well. But I hope you enjoyed that. This has been pretty awesome. I'm excited to see the rest of it. But for now, I'll see you on the next one, and peace.